In this illustration, we intend to simulate the FRP reinforced masonry wall in the Abacus software. FRP has been affixed to the wall by adhesive. In the left picture, you can observe the masonry wall without FRP, and in the right picture you can see the masonry wall having been reinforced by FRP. In the next step, I'll select fail stress from sub-option menu. The tensile stress limit in the fiber direction is equal to 1500 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. The compressive stress limit in the fiber direction is negative 700 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. Tensile stress limit in the transverse direction is 90 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. Compressive stress limit in the transverse direction is equal to negative 140 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal, and the shear strength in fiber plane is equal to 6 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal. I will enter these quantities as 0, 0. In all cases, tensile values must be positive and compressive values must be negative. OK, and click on OK. In the next step, I will click on Translate Instance, select FRP. First, I'll select this point, then this one, and OK. Here, tick on Specify Stiffness Coefficient. KNN is the stiffness of adhesive in the normal direction, the quantity of which is equal to 4.16 multiplied by 10 to the power of 12. KSS is actually the stiffness of adhesive in the first shear direction, the quantity of which is equal to 1.73 multiplied by 10 to the power of 12. And KTT is the stiffness of adhesive in the second shear direction, the quantity of which is equal to, select damage initiation criteria, also a failure measure component, in the right picture you can observe the masonry wall having been reinforced by FRP, and in the left picture the masonry wall without FRP can be observed. As you observe, rocking failure mode has been created in a masonry wall without FRP, while in a masonry wall having been reinforced by FRP, the rocking failure mode has been prevented and no rocking failure mode has been created in a masonry wall having been reinforced by FRP, and you can observe that here. Actually, it has caused masonry wall to be reinforced and has prevented from its failure mode. Here, we intend to compare the equivalent plastic strain in a masonry wall without FRP and that having been reinforced by FRP. As you can observe, in these two pictures, the equivalent plastic strain has lowered in a masonry wall having been reinforced by FRP, while the equivalent plastic strain has been higher by far in the masonry wall without FRP, which we can observe in this part in this picture. Actually, toe crushing has been considerably lower in the masonry wall, having been reinforced by FRP. Here we intend to evaluate Sai Hill, Saivu and Azi-Sai Hill failure criterion, which are used for composites. First, I will select Sai Hill failure criterion. According to this criterion, if the quantities of Sai Hill is lower than 1, the composite will not sustain damage and failure, and if Sai Hill quantities are higher than 1, the composite will sustain damage and failure. As you can observe here, Sai Hill quantities are lower than 1, so the composite will not sustain damage and failure. In the next step, I will select Saivu failure criterion. According to this criterion, if the quantities of Saivu are lower than 1, the composite will not sustain damage and failure, and if the quantities of Saivu are higher than 1, the composite will sustain damage and failure.